Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Akansha Parimu. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 25th of July. Two militants gunned down in encounter in India's Jammu and Kashmir. Indian Prime Minister addresses Parliament of Uganda. And Pakistanis vote in cliffhanger general election. And now for all the details. Security forces gunned down two militants in an encounter in Anantnag district of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir province on Wednesday. Police officials claim these slain militants belong to Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Taiba terror group.
Two militants were killed in an encounter with security forces in Anantnag district of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir province on Wednesday. The gunfight broke out after a joint team of Indian Army, Police and paramilitary Central Reserve Police Force laid a siege at Lal Chowk area of the district. The security personnel had already been carrying out search and cordon operation in the area since Tuesday night. Security officials claim the slain militants belong to Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Taiba militant group. In recent months, the province has witnessed a huge spike in militant attacks. On Tuesday, an Indian soldier was killed and two others sustained bullet injuries after militants attacked a CRPF party in Srinagar's Batmalu area. India accuses Pakistan of regularly arming and infiltrating militants across the border to spread unrest in the Kashmir Valley. Pakistan denies the allegation.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday addressed the Parliament of Uganda a day after extending a $200 million credit line to the African nation. In his address, he underlined that India is proud to be Africa's partner and Uganda is central in this on the African continent.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi became the first Indian leader to address the Parliament of Uganda in its capital, Kampala City, on Wednesday. The Indian Prime Minister described Uganda as Pearl of Africa. He said it is a land of great wealth of resources and rich heritage. Referring to Indian freedom fighter Mahatma Gandhi's 21-year stay in South Africa, Prime Minister Modi said the story of India's independence was closely linked to Africa.
The dawn of the new opportunities and the new unity of aspirations of our young population. All of this connects us. Mr. President, our people are among the many threads that connect Uganda and India together.
Earlier on Tuesday, getting straight down to business, Prime Minister Modi held a one-on-one meeting with the President of Uganda. Following the delegation-level talks, Prime Minister Modi extended a credit line worth $200 million to Uganda government for the development of infrastructure, dairy and agriculture sector of the African country. Later on Wednesday, he was scheduled to travel to South Africa, where he is expected to participate in a special outreach session for BRICS leaders.
In news from Pakistan, Pakistanis on Wednesday voted in the cliffhanger general election for the country's second ever democratic transition of power. Results were to start trickling in within hours after the voting ended at 6 p.m. and the likely winner was expected to be known by early Thursday.
Pakistanis on Wednesday voted in a general election for the country's second ever democratic transition of power. Polling got underway across the country at 8 a.m. as Pakistan's nearly 106 million registered voters got a chance to choose their representatives in the national and provincial assemblies as well as their next prime minister. Recent nationwide polls projected a tight race between cricketer-turned-politician Imran Khan's party and the party of jailed ex-prime minister Nawaz Sharif. The people hoped the polls will deliver change and ease frustrations of a feeble economy, widespread corruption, chronic power cuts, and crumbling infrastructure. Results were to start trickling in within hours, and the likely winner was expected to be known by early Thursday.
डाले अपना इसी उम्मीद के साथ के मुल्क के हालात बदले और चेंज आए और हमारे बच्चों के लिए और आप सब के और हमारे जितने भी लोग हैं जो गरीब लोग हैं उनके लिए कोई बेहतरी इस मुल्क में कोई निजाम ऐसा बने कि वो सब भी वो सारी चीजों का मजा ले सकें जो हम अफोर्ड कर सकते हैं वो वाली क्लास जो उनके लिए बराबरी हो.
Despite tight security arrangements, a blast targeting police officials near a polling station killed at least 29 in the western city of Quetta on Wednesday. The explosion, which came shortly after the country began voting in the cliffhanger election, was claimed by militant group Islamic State. Pakistan's election authorities had granted broad judicial powers to the powerful military at polling stations to prevent such attacks.
In news from Afghanistan, 7 members of one family were wounded in a rocket attack in Afghan capital Kabul on Tuesday. The attack came just 2 days after a suicide bombing outside the international airport in Kabul claimed the lives of at least 27 people and wounded over 100.
At least 7 people from one family were wounded in a rocket attack on a civilian area in Afghan capital Kabul on Tuesday. 3 rocket explosions happened shortly after one another killing the family. Residents in the area reported that another 3 rockets landed after the first 3 by afternoon. The attack comes just 2 days after a suicide bombing outside the international airport in Kabul claimed the lives of at least 27 people and wounded over 100. The incident happened after country's once exiled first vice president, General Abdul Rashid Dostum, arrived back in Afghanistan after having spent 13 months in Turkey.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Nepal's Law Minister Sher Bahadur Tamang, who came under criticism over his remarks on Nepalese female students studying medicine in Bangladesh, resigned on Tuesday. He claimed he was under pressure from within his party and was quitting on moral grounds.
Nepal's Minister for Law, Justice and Parliamentary Affairs Sher Bahadur Tamang announced his resignation on Tuesday, following widespread criticism over his controversial remarks on female students pursuing medical degrees in Bangladesh. While announcing the decision during a press meet, Tamang said he had resigned on moral grounds. He had last week said female students from Nepal pursuing MBBS degrees in Bangladesh had to sell themselves to earn their certificates. In his resignation letter, Tamang blamed the internal and external forces of Nepal Communist Party for compelling him to step down. Nepal's first federal government, led by Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli, was formed on February 15th this year, and the government had been pressured high to scrap him off from his responsibilities. The government has also reportedly started working on appointing a new law minister.
Indian Army on Tuesday celebrated its 19th victory anniversary of the 1999 Kargil War in India's Jammu and Kashmir province with demonstration of Bofors guns. The soldiers, as part of the celebration, were also seen climbing rocks, belaying their fellow soldiers, conducting mock drills during the training program.
Indian Army and the Kargil Battle School in India's Jammu and Kashmir conducted a demonstration of Bofors guns and carried out battle training to mark the 19th anniversary of the victory in a war with Pakistan in 1999 on Tuesday. The soldiers were seen climbing rocks, belaying their fellow soldiers, conducting mock drills, including carrying an injured soldier while rappelling down the hills. The soldier also participated in a physical training session before celebrating the anniversary.
ये गन बहुत ही एक्यूरेट है, फुली ऑटोमेटिक है और ये गन 14 सेकंड में 3 राउंड तक निकालने की क्षमता रखती है. मैक्सिमम रेंज इस जगह पर 40 किलोमीटर के अप्रॉक्सिमेटली मिलती है, क्योंकि यहाँ पर हवा का घर्षण कम है तो शेल को फ्रिक्शन कम मिलता है तो ज़्यादा रेंज मिल जाती है.
वी कैरी आउट अ 3 वीक ट्रेनिंग इन विच द फर्स्ट वीक इज डेडिकेटेड टू एक्लिमेटाइजेशन. द सेकेंड एंड थर्ड वीक वी आर ट्रेनिंग देम फॉर स्ट्रेंथ ट्रेनिंग, टेक्निकल क्लाइंबिंग, डिजास्टर अवेयरनेस. And also, we give them an introduction to icecraft.
The Kargil War was an armed conflict between India and Pakistan that took place in summer of 1999 in Kargil district and elsewhere along the line of control in Kashmir. The conflict, which claimed the lives of nearly 500 soldiers, many of whom were posthumously given gallantry awards, is also referred to as Operation Vijay.
A strawberry farm was launched on Tuesday as an addition to an integrated farm set up by two female entrepreneurs in India's northeastern Nagaland province. The farm, which was set up a year back, aims to provide employment to the locals and motivate female farmers to take up farming as an occupation.
An integrated farm set up by two female entrepreneurs in India's eastern Nagaland province is flourishing after a few strawberry field was launched as part of the project on Tuesday. The Tishora, meaning thank you, integrated farm was started by Lopilo Kikon and Yamna Machin in Punkalwa village near Dimapur city more than a year back with an aim to boost the grassroots economy of the region. The farm also puts emphasis on providing employment to the local youth and motivate female farmers to take up farming as an occupation.
The fertility of the soil, everything, and then like we just thought like, why don't we start a small project? And then like we started last year, and then the soil fertility as well as the weather conditions is very favorable. And like that has just boosted us up.
They are having a successful farm of bird, poultry, vegetable farming, and many initiatives they have taken, and the recent one being strawberry cultivation, which we have launched this morning. We will, as a department, we will try to extend all possible support, and we will keep on encouraging them.
The areas near the Punkwa village are blessed with fertile soil, desired climate, and abundance of water sources, which make it a favorable place to carry out farming. Two-thirds of India's 1.3 billion people depend directly or indirectly on farming for their livelihood, but farm incomes only account for 14% of gross domestic product.
A prison in India's Jammu and Kashmir has introduced rehabilitation programs for inmates to reform their behavior and help them have self-sustaining future ahead. The programs include activities like special tailoring and sewing tuitions, repairing electrical items, and also training to females as how to run a beauty parlor.
A prison in India's northern Jammu and Kashmir province has introduced a series of rehabilitation programs for the inmates at the faculty to perform their behaviors and help them have self-sustaining future ahead. The authorities at the district jail Amphala in Jammu have initiated recreational activities which include special tailoring, sewing tuitions and repairing electrical items. For female inmates, the rehabilitation program specially involves training as how to work in a beauty parlor.
पहले हमने ब्यूटी पार्लर सीखा था तीन महीने फिर इसके बाद हमने बैगेज बनाना सीखे इसमें हम लंच बॉक्स बनाते हैं और वॉल हैंगिंग बनाते हैं और फाइल कवर बनाते हैं हाँ हमने बहुत कुछ सीखा है हम अपना काम कर सकते हैं
मैसेज को हम ये देना चाहते हैं जो भी गलती से या कैसे भी डेलिबरेट जिसने कोई क्राइम किया जेल में आया है उसका बिहेवियर उसको टोटली हम लोग पूरा कोशिश करते हैं हमारा प्रोसेस ये रहता है उसको रिफॉर्म करना है प्रॉपरली ताकि मेन स्ट्रीम सोसाइटी में वो जाए हमारा ऑब्जेक्टिव यही होता है कि वो अपना क्राइम को पीछे के दिनों को भूल जाए और मेन स्ट्रीम सोसाइटी में जाकर लॉ अबाइडिंग सिटीजन बने
A shop has also been established by the name of Sudhar Bikri Kendra, meaning Rehabilitation Sales Center in the city, which provides the handicraft products made by the prisoners available for sale to the public.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.